All right, so this is the second part of the video where we're looking at this lab. And the point of this lab is to start to get comfortable with the idea that functions take steps to do. So for example, we've got this factorial and we created a factorial function and we counted the number of floating point operations in a very, very non-scientific way just to kind of start getting used to the idea. So now what we're going to do is we're going to create n choose k in three different ways and talk about how the operation count affects it. And even though some things might have a higher operation count, they're actually more effective. So the n choose k is, again, the whole idea is if you have a group of five people, how many different ways of three can you sort them in? How many different groups of three can you put them in? And so every software, or math, library file now is going to have an n choose k in it. But there's actually lots of different ways to put this together, and so we're going to compare all of these. It's going to be super fun. All right, so we're going to start with this one. And so if we're doing n choose k, this is a product, so this is a multiplication. I is going from 1 to k, just exactly what you see here. So we've kind of done stuff similar to this whenever we did the factorial. So here, I'll go put that up for you. So this is our factorial that we did, and it was kind of similar. So try and take a minute and see if you can take this and program a function that does this and gets it started. Okay, so we'll assume you did that. So I'm going to start off by going, all right, you got a function, it's got y, an operation count, and what am I calling it? Nk using a product. Okay, Nk product, I can't spell, Nk, product. And then n choose k. Okay, so hopefully looking at this, your first thought is I'm gonna do a for loop. And you can just read this for loop right off. For I going from 1 to k, oops, I can't type. For I going from 1 to k, we're gonna do something. And what we're gonna do is every time we go through the loop, we're going to multiply this term by the previous term. So y is gonna be equal to y times. So it's going to be n plus 1 minus I over I. Alrighty. So that is the, well, that's the term. And then we need an initial value for y. And you got to think, what is this initial value going to be? Alrighty. So since we're multiplying, that means that I said I is equal to 1 to k. There we go. And whenever I start out with y, and I'm doing multiplication, I always want to start off with a 1. Okay, now I'm using I, and a lot of MATLAB people don't like that because technically I in MATLAB is the square root of negative 1. It doesn't matter because I'm doing this in a function that's all in and of itself. If it makes you upset, you can call it index, and then I can hit shift enter, so then it'll be index. So if you want to do index instead of I, like, I totally get it. So y starts at 1, and then I'm going to, well, save this and then just start doing stuff. Okay, now I also want to count the operations. And kind of like when we did the factorial count, every time we go through here, we're going to add the number of operations that we've done, or that we're going to have done, or whatever. All right, so I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, I think. Okay, yeah, I'm down with 4. And since I have to have a previous value of op count, since I'm adding, the neutral is 0. Look at y'all learning stuff. This is kind of amazing. All right, so it says to test it. I have to ask for both outputs. So I'm going to call it nk product, and I'm going to throw in a 9 and a 4 and see what answer I get. 126 and 16. Awesome. So I'm on track. This is what I'm trying to do. All right, so it takes, in theory, 16 operations to make this happen. And yeah, I shouldn't get into this meta discussion of like, well, technically you've added another one here, and there's like secret ones in here, and yeah, I'm just shush, shush. We're not doing that. We're just getting a basic idea of how many operations this takes. There's a really, really, really fancy ways to do this, and it's like a whole other brain thing, and this is just us getting a sense of it. Okay, so this is, please don't yell at me because you're not getting a good big O notation lecture. That's not the point. We're just kind of messing around in MATLAB and having a good time. All right, let's do the next one. So whenever I first learned n choose k, this is the function that I was taught, the n factorial over n minus k factorial times k factorial. Now, mechanically, this is a really good one to have, like if you're in a math class or something like that, because it's straightforward, it's relatively easy to do. You can shove it straight into the calculator. You don't have to explain for loops to people, which you'd kind of have to do with the other. Okay, and the reason we like teaching people this is because, like, let's say I was going to do 9 choose 4 or something like that. Then the 9 goes on the top, and then the n minus k would be 5 factorial over 4 factorial. And so usually, let me make this pretty, well, not that pretty. Usually what we do whenever we're trying to teach people factorials is we try to get them to go, oh, so basically 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 times 5 factorial over 5 factorial, 4 factorial. And we go, look it, look it, look it. The 5 factorials cancel out. And so you're basically left with whatever 9 times 8 times 7 times 6 over 4 times 3 times 2 times 1, which is a little bit easier for us to do mechanically. So then they would come in and yeah, just do that. 9, 8, 7, 6 divided by 4, 3, 2, well, I guess 1, and you get the 126. So that's how we teach it usually, because then you can talk to them about how, oh, look, I can cancel the 5 factorials out, which we'll discover later actually works kind of against us in programming. Okay. All that said, again, my recommendation, try and pause this video and see if you can put this together. Now, in order to count the operations, you're going to need to use the operation count factorial function that we created in the previous video. And if you missed the video but you want to see it, this is what it was. So you can just copy that. This is our factorial count function where we counted the number of operations in the factorial. And so you're going to have to use this. So I know there's built-in factorial operation or built-in factorials in MATLAB, but we're going to use R specifically so we can do the operation count. Okay, so we'll pretend that you did that. So I've got function y up count and then nk factorial with n choose k like that. Save it as nk factorial. All right, look at all these functions we got going here. We like all kinds of fancy. Okay, so this one doesn't have a for loop. So what we can say, we can kind of break this up. I'm probably going to do, just to make this easier on myself, I'm going to do the, and I'm going to kind of do it in 3 separate spots. I'm going to do the top part, I'm going to do the left bottom part, and I'm going to do the right bottom part. And that's just for no particular reason. So I have to ask for both outputs for my factorial function. Because if I just put in my factorial count and I only give it like a 5, it's going to give me the factorial of 120. But if I want to know how many operations, I would have to actually ask, hey, give me the y and the operations. So whenever I'm doing this, I have to ask for the factorial and the number of operations. So I'm going to use my factorial count of n. So now maybe if you were kind of stuck before, you can keep going. And if not, you know, that's okay. You just keep watching and doing math, then it'll be fine. So the ops 2 is going to be my factorial count of n minus k. And then the right bottom part is going to be ops 3 of my factorial count of k. All right, and then my answer is going to be the top part divided by the left bottom part times the right bottom part, like that. All right, so that's going to be the output. And if I just kind of want to check and make sure I'm getting the right answer, I can just run nk factorial of 9 choose 4, and there's the 126. So I haven't asked for that second. If I try to ask for both outputs now, it would yell at me because I haven't actually defined it yet. So, okay, so let's see what the operation count would be. So it's tempting to just say the op count is going to be the ops 1 plus the ops 2 plus the ops 3. But in fact, you're missing several operations there. So take a minute and see if you can figure out what these would be. All right, so hopefully, maybe you're finding this one here. So there's an extra one in this negative sign. And then here's one here, and here's one here. So this is actually plus another two. So the total operations is going to be the top and the two bottoms plus three, and that's the total number of operations. All right, and again, yes, metacognitively or whatever, we can say, oh, there's all these extra ones. That's all we're doing. Okay, so now I'm going to ask for the two outputs. So basically, what this is saying is that it still got the answer of 126, and it had to do 18 addition, subtraction, multiplication, division to get there. So let's compare that to the other one with the NK. So doing it by a product got me the answer faster. If you want to count, like if we pretend, you know, each operation costs us a dollar, this one's cheaper, and the one we just made is more expensive. Alrighty? Okay, so we're gonna do one more. Okay, this is a recursive definition of N choose K, which honestly I had never seen before, and it's like crazy. And so I don't want to get distracted here. I'm going to put this in another video how this works because it's super weird. But I kind of want to show you. So it's whenever I show you how it works, that's going to totally inform your brain on why this actually is an absolutely brilliant formulation. Okay, so this one's a little weird, but if you want to go ahead and give it a shot, also look how high that operation count's going to be. It's going to be huge. Huge operation count. Okay, so let's throw this in here. All right, so I've got function nk, oh, sorry, I got y op count, and then nk recursion of n choose k. And I'm going to save it, and it's beautiful. Okay, so we always want to start these recursive thingies with kind of our base case. So our base, we actually have two base cases. Base case is, okay. We have if, see if n, if the top one is, so I get confused in this because I always want to say if n equals zero, but that's not what it is. If, see this up here is our n. You're like, yes, it says n, but this is n and this is k. Okay, so if n is equal to, if, sorry, if k is equal to zero, or if n is equal to k, then we're done. So we don't really need to worry because n is always equal to n. But if our k value is zero, or our k value is the same thing as n, then that means we're done. Okay? And you don't have to understand why, because that's not what we're doing in this particular video. We'll do that in a second. We're just specifically looking at a base case for our recursion. So if k is equal to zero, or, so that's the or symbol in MATLAB. It's a pipe, I guess. I don't know exactly what it's called, but it's the thingy that's above the enter key and below the backspace. It's shift button below the backspace. So if k is equal to zero or k is equal to n, then we're done and the answer is one. All right. Otherwise, we're going to have to do a couple of things. So that was our base case. So instead, if we're not in our base case, we're in our non-base case. Does that help? So our non-base case would say, okay, so we're actually going to have two different answers. We're going to have a first answer and a second answer. Okay, and our final answer would be the first one plus the second one. Alrighty, so that's what we're looking for. Now, the idea is if we want to get to the first answer, so by the first answer, I mean this one. Okay, so this is a recursive function. So I would normally say I'm going to do nk recursion of n minus 1 times k minus 1, or not times, but n minus 1, comma, k minus 1, because I'm running this the second time. So n minus 1, k minus 1. All right, so I'm doing the nk recursion, n minus 1, k minus 1. Now, because I'm being obnoxious and asking for an operation count, I'm going to have to ask for an operation to count for this one too. Okay, so I have to call the nk recursion for n minus 1 and k minus 1. I'm gonna have to do the same thing for this one, is the n minus 1 in k. So again, I'll also have to ask for an op count there. Nk recursion, I can't spell recursion, recursion of n minus 1 in k. Okay, got it? All right, so then in theory, my op count would be, first of all, you'd say, okay, op 1 plus op 2, but there's some more to this. Now, before I get too much into counting operations, let's go ahead and just run it without asking for that second one. And let's see if we get the right answer. Recursion of 9 choose 4. Oh gosh, it yells at me. Oh, because it needs that. Okay, because it is recursive. I guess I can't just put this off. Okay, so the op count, it's yelling at me because... Okay, so it's yelling at me for line... Apparently line 7 a whole lot. That's probably because it's running it a whole lot. So I'm like, but that's really weird because I defined op count right there, except this value is eventually coming from the base case, and I never actually defined it in the base case. So how many operations are happening in the base case? I'm going with none. There's none counts, none operations going on in the base case. All right, so I guess I gotta be serious about this. How many, let's see. There's two more operations here, and there's one more operation here, and one more operation here. So this would be plus 4. Okay, so I'm gonna suppress all these because I really don't want to see all the 500 operations it's gonna have to go through adding things up 4 at a time. All right, so let's do this again. I'm gonna ask for the two outputs for the recursion. There we go, 126 and 500. All right, so this is preparing to learn the fun stuff. And so like my next step that I'm gonna do in the next video, actually in the next video, I'm gonna show you how this lovely recursive function works just because it's super cool. And then in the next video, I'm going to compare finding n choose k with the three different methods.